Hello guys, I've made a tier list of 100 tomes total, because I have the modded tomes in there, so I'm gonna show how it's done. Oh wait, this is meant to be swapped. You go green. You go purple. And I'm going to rank the tomes. Mid is mid, of course. You have bad. Yeah, never will be barely used. And best is for broken stuff. And yeah. Because it's over 100 total. You have to be a bit quick with this one. So let's get started. Put them by tome. Okay, even Valor first. It's the inverse of the tome of the Horde. And you can pause if you want to see the descriptions. Yeah, of course you want to go with Moral. It is an Order Chaos tome. And the ones with the background, I've cut them out. And the vanilla ones, yeah, if you just grab the images of the wiki. Yeah, so the Valor tome that here. For example, yeah. And this is very nice to have, of course, at a low tier. This gives some damage at lifesteal, but the lifesteal is weaker than Whiteborn for obvious balancing reasons. But you get a nice combat summon, which you will deny corpses from necromancers on its spawn. And it can use it to regain health and in turn deny even more corpses. Now you don't want to use meters on the menu. Sacrificing a unit for those tiny bonuses. Yeah, that's just not something you would want to do. And maybe late game if you can summon spam. It's going good here. Vice. This is the first of the three rogue tomes from Age of Wonder. Yeah, inspired by Age of Wonders 3. So you get flanker on your units. Not sure if this spawns with the ratio thing. But I think it does, because this one gives effect. And this one gives damage, and damage usually stacks. And those guys you can summon, and just like the zealot, die kost gold. So that is nice to have. So is the black market. Okay, where's the Vice? Good tome. Hoort. Beloved by many, but it's not going to be in the top tier. Because these tier 1 units, at the mid and late game, they will be useless anyway. Or you have to send waves and waves of dry stacks. 3 times 6 to weaken everyone. But if you combine this with Valor, you're going to have a very nice transition in the higher tiers. So it's good, but it's just not amazing, as people claim it to be. Ja, Pyromancy is de first bad tier. I only have this on because it's my Dagot Ur character I've loaded in. Empty, I haven't nothing yet. Of course the starting tome. Yeah, but it's just I rather want to go with Cryo instead of this. And just that is a team that's going to come back with the other tier 1 elemental tomes. But yeah, I roleplay with it because yeah, roleplaying, eh? I can use this to start a demoralizing build. And, yeah, this is going to pay off later because in tier 1 you're not going to get pure evil yet. I'm not sure if intimidating aura stacks with itself, but it, nonetheless it's nice to have. I had a kit in my class called a newer kit from my camp. It's called Ryan. I'm obsessed with penguins, so thanks to him I will never forget that this is meant to be a macaroni penguin. But yeah, it's a good dome. And it was made by the devs, so you can say it's a semi-official. It's an example mod. Yeah, and a modder has made this new and improved book cover. So if you go to the Steam Workshop, give these modders a thumbs up. And if you're an artist and you want to help out, something you can do. Soul Drift is currently broken. It doesn't give you the souls. Yeah, diseased, so you get minus 1 status resistance net. So we can, yeah, and the civilian zombies are weaker than the scouts, which summon 6 of them at tier 1. So it's very useful to scare away the AI, because they still see an army of tier 1s. Or to spread them out and pillage. So it has its uses. Can also use them to front ranged units, but they're very weak, and even even melee tier 1 units will often one hit these guys. But the storm is going in best because the disease transformation on your race is going to be busted with the Tome of Blight in tier 2, and you get to it when you get to it. Zeal. Yeah, the Zealot is the cutthroat. It is beloved and with good reason. Mana to summon, gold to upkeep. And you have far more gold to spare anyway. Even as Mystic, if you max everything, the gold income is going to is going to be above mana. Yeah, this one I personally never used. But I can see it having its uses. Yeah, and you need this to start your zeal, but it's good on its own, so yeah. Tomes that are meh on its own, but are needed to start a build, will go in mid automatically, unless you're so bad, but we'll get to that soon. That yeah, that only you need it to start a build, but the tome itself sucks. This is not that bad, you get shock unit, low tier is good to have. This is a very boring, yeah, but very a simple damage spell. That's what it says on the tin. Nothing less and nothing more. Yeah, people give this low. But I would make the Toomfrog a mid. Yeah, it's an exciting, but it's it doesn't deserve to be hated. This I never used. Now those guys are always nice to have. I think they evolve, but let me check. Yes. Yeah, there is no silver golem, so it doesn't make much sense. Yeah, one range, nice to have if you have everything set up. This will hit well too. But without setup, it isn't too reliable. Yeah, enchantment is mid. Yeah, it can make your guys a bit beefier. That team we are going to see reoccur is that the higher the tier of the tome, the less practical. Yeah, now it shows up in game. I had a problem it not showing up, and now it does. So yeah. Yeah. I wouldn't call this very calming now, would I? It's for tier one. Yeah, this is a proper proper punishment. I think it's a half the HP of some tier 1 units. Yeah, that's like getting hit with a shotgun blast in the belly and saying you are trying to calm them. But yeah. Yeah, I would have used clones this ability. Because it being healing sap, I don't know if it makes much sense. I just clone it and name it healing tea. But flavor and art, they are not going to deduct from my scoring. So the center deals 30 or what? Okay, this is glorious. Let's be real. Yeah, but wouldn't this deal fire damage? Yeah, it's very good for tier 1. Let's see, because it says what's the rank. Yeah, it's not busted. But it's very good. Just short of soup, yeah, of best. Hier. And ordering doesn't matter. I consider them equal, unless I say it's on the border of something. So don't think about it too much. I think Sacred Oil was in Age of Wonders 3 as well. So that this dome is based on that. And the race transformation is nice because like you can offset the status resistance from the disease transformation if you want to. And in general it's something nice to have. And put it in good. Fate. Yeah, this is nice with the high culture, of course. And status removal is nice to have because this will break decay and it decays powerful. And this will help you recover faster so you can enter another fight or defend or whatever you want. And city stability bonuses. Yeah, you should be in harmony at around late mid game and at the early end game. You should have harmony in your cities, unless if you're dark. If it is a solid good tier. Yeah, this one is a lot of fun to mess around with. Because you can use it to escape. Yeah, or attack further. I always play with the Hero Resurgence on it, just always. If I can use the Hero to get more damage in with the invulnerable on. Yes, yeah, especially with Awakening, this is nice, because get that added on top. Yeah, it can do this with Radiance. Yeah, we see a lot of defensive enchantments for your race. I like warding. I think it deserves a spot on good. There it goes. Yeah, not very much tomes are actually bad. This game is surprisingly well balanced. Yeah, this is one of them. The same reason as the Fire Tome. Yeah, Evocation is going in bad. Yeah, the Age of Wonders 3 shapeshifters. You get two units in one. And don't know if they still have move points after the transformation. But even if they don't, it's still very good. At dusk, ghosting goat. Astrology is... the idea is that those predictions, they will help you later on. And it's of course nice to have to get to harmonies faster. That you get a bit of grit with this. Yeah, the transformation enchantment save this one from bad. But the battles are too unstable and predictable to really make that work. AI barely knows what it's doing, so you sure as hell can't. But of course you can predict, and it's right most of the time. Those guys don't summon these. They're very frail. They're not a Tyran combat unit. They're closer to a scout. Just ignore these. And Slitter is good. It's early skirmisher for you. This is why people love it. But it's not a best tier. Because for best tier you really have to be really strong, and that's not the case, but it's still a good tone. Beast. Yeah, if you have a racial mount trait, this is going to play very nice with it. So that's something to consider. Okay, where is Beast at? And this is take 4 of this video, so I got used to it. And this is a new one, and it goes all the way to tier 4. Ocean build. Doesn't do what you want it to do, but it's still good as due to the obstacle damage too. And it's all about making things wet, so I am quite versed with this storm. Yeah, but it's not as good as other tomes, but you need to start the build off. This is what I mean with the cornerstone tome. That's bad, but you still need it to start the build off. At least in vanilla, else you can go with the Restless Dead. This guy's way too frail, and it no longer gets bigger like in the third game. I can no longer have fun trying to make it as big as possible. Seems to have lost its stock of Viagra. The only two spells you want this tome for are these two. You do not want to waste souls on this or that. And you don't want this unit. It is very easy to take out. It gets no ratio bonuses either. So it's stuck with those elemental weaknesses. And this one is another one I love. This one is too weak. Yeah. And maybe it's okay for a starting spell. Because it's the lowest of the lowest tier. Okay, if you have 6 of these witches. In general, they can defend the city well, but at the higher tiers you need to upgrade, of course. I used aggressive AI mod, so city siege things on the defensive side. That will those tomes will be elevated in my ranking due to that. because it's no longer dead content. And this is why you may want to build status resistance. But it's Spawnkin and Hide the Nasty, I think. If the casualties, you still do more damage. Yeah, you can stack it that way. Yeah, but it's risky. And your guys, their eyes will glow purple. I like it personally. And advice with the flanking transformation. You get blood spatters on the face. So that may be something you'd love to do. I know I do. Yeah, that is the best elemental tome. Yeah, because of the slope. But this spell gets outclassed by something we will see after the tome, in the Tome of Arachnid. And the Tome of Arachnid is broken. So, we're going on to the Steam page and we're going to read about it. You get two evolvable units. And you get something that gives ranks to the units. And we just talked about the Evolution Tome. And this is why you, Ice Coffin is outclassed, this spell. And yeah, with the Evolution Tome together. Yeah, this was made, as you see, it's broken now. It just doesn't do anything. And you can't get new tomes, so it'll just break your game. But I hope it will be fixed, and I wanted to review it anyway. But, because Evolution is now out, if you do it with Evolution, yeah, it becomes very good. On the line with best, but not quite, I feel. Okay, next one. Roots. Yeah, people say you want it for this. If we have dark, so at least can heal. This guy is far too frail. It's even frailer than the Wyvern, but at least it can range. So that's a plus. Yeah, and this is of course fun because it... It really upsets the AI. That was Roots, right? Yes. And this one you just use to start the Dark Fire build of a Shadow Flame build. This one, doesn't play by wet. That's nice because it ignores wet, of course. Soul Income, very good. Yeah, I would give it mid, but a soul income saves it from mid. So it's going to into good. Siren. Yeah, it's a tier 2 of the water tomes. Yeah, lightning, of course, more damage with water. Yeah, if we're going for summon build, this is not too bad anyway. Ja, Water Combat is very underbaked currently. So yeah, that's a bit of a shame. But at least this build buffs your coastal province of your water provinces. But yeah, it's just not the water isn't worked out very well in the game, or at least not yet. And this stacks with regeneration because of it's another thing. And this guy is very good. And you get the shapeshift, same with this one. Yeah, and a new fire type again. Gives good healing. So yeah, Dark may want this. And gives Shadow Fan Infinity too. Now this guy's awesome because the shield. But it can heal, it's a nice hybrid to have. And you get resistance, and it synergizes with forest. This weakens guy, this weakens enemies for your other archers or melee, yeah, to attack. Yeah, defensive stuff, and starts of your forest build. Yeah, bleed and nature build tome is this. Very nice unit to have. Okay, it's about plants. Yeah, that's what it should do. I've played all the affinities in the game, but not all tomes yet. I'm confident to review these. Ik op het in mid, because the moonfire stuff and the damage is a bit of a pain to set up. I love this one. This is basically improved vines. Of course, you can have them both. But these guys, you can push support and battle mages away, because they AI will think. Yeah, I don't want to be here. I don't want to have this melee guy in front of me. I'm going to run back and attack. And a support will often be too far to do its support thing. This is good for long battles. This is good in a pinch. Yeah, because you can actually destroy city structures. It is buried a bit, but you have to go to the cork wheel and yeah, you can go from there. This is useless. But I love this tome. very fun to harass with. And this is the one I managed to cut out myself. And this is a bad one. Because the only fairy you want is Summer. Because it has the heal. The other fairies you want ignore. But the Summer fairy is in the opposite version of this dome. Yeah, that 20% is not enough to waste that dome on. Unseelie is just a bad dome. A tier 2 thieving tome. Yeah, mind control is very powerful. So is this cold blooded. If you're not undead, that's I think the best way to reduce morale from an enemy. Nee, je want Dome of Whispers. Look, the problem with this Dome is... The Banshee is just better than the Corrupt Zone every way. Nee, this is okay, I guess, but your heroes can do it. You're not going to have death magic yet, so you want to save your casting points. And this is the another healing. It is going to be a lot more useful once you hit Whiteborn. And decay, spread it around. It's going to help you. And this is the same as the It's the same as with the other stuff here. It's only going to really kick off at Whiteborn. And on its own, it's really not good. This tome is over here. Yeah, this tome deserves more love. Bench is very good at demoralizing. And you get a weaken on top. And this before you start. This is spammable, especially with Wizard King or Wizard King heroes. Yeah, morale is overpowered, but it gets absolutely blocked by undead. Like, it deserves to be in good. Yeah, it doesn't say what this does, so I have to consider that broken. Yeah, this contains your Shadow Flame. Saw income, nice. Yeah, this is broken. You're not meant to cross magma, but it's a ton of fun to do anyway. And you get to terraform the underground. And the underground is bad. In a tree, the underground was it was just right. You could actually spend an entire game in the underground. Swans. Yeah, this is good with your forest terraforming build. Because bring the floodplains. It stacks with forest anyway. You can have wetland. And you can have forest on one province. So yeah, nice to have transformation as well. so we can channel your inner Shrek. This is the good one, get the best fairy. Yeah, it's supportive, obviously. And utility. And you can stack this up with primal strike. Yeah, this is another one that's going into best. Look, this is just tier 2, and you get this. This is why it's so high up in best. But it's not so incredibly broken, I would consider that cheat. I have had AI, because you get the transformation, make your guys diseased, and you get to spam parasitic growth. It's not unbeatable, but just very, very strong as of current. This is bad, because that measly damage is not going to do anything at all. But you may as well if. Yeah, in the third game. This was amazing, but now it's let down. Those guys stack. And you have another Covenant. This is the vanilla game, of course. You have Convert, always nice. But you want to put the status weakness on an enemy first to mind control them. You don't get to keep the units as a down. Let down. You get to cheaply summon to tier 3 to a vassal, and if you're like me, you like to put vassals near competitor empires, and you reinforce them with this for pretty cheap. Yeah, it's not going to get captured anytime soon. Inquisition. Yeah, this is useless. Because, the AI is going to. And maybe if you want to run away, I guess. And this gives zeal to more units. Stability. Nice to have. And the Tithe Collectors. Nice to have as well. Fertility. And it just doesn't refer to the fruit because I'm not going to say much about this one. But mind controller, nice of course. Poison spores hits hard. Unit is pretty frail, especially for a tier 2. This thing is way overpriced, don't be fooled. Yeah, I'm not sure if Restore the Land works with if you've cooled the magma with the other tome. But if it does, that's a fun thing you can play around with. The fertility is going up high. Yeah, this game is very well made, so. Oh no, that's the wrong one. Artificing, I love this one. Best siege defense and attack unit. 3 strikes, get to attack each turn. And this you want for siege breaker. And not for demolisher. You're not going to use magic attacks to destroy a wall. Just silly. If you don't undermine the walls, yeah, what are you even doing sieging? I mean, yeah, that does what it says on the tin. This is just really good on its own already. Yeah, I love artificing personally. Yeah, there's a reason why the Sky Nomads in Avatar Last Airbender was absolutely destroyed. This is why. Astral Blood alone is why you want this. Chain Lightning is bad. Damage isn't good enough for my taste. Ik had Frenzy. And those guys are fun to summon in the back of an enemy army. The enemy will prioritize these weak hitting things, the towers. And go for them. And you turn your backs to you and you're gonna step in the backs. Nice and hard. Amplification gets in good. Mayhem, Wojak Face Dome. Yeah, Gremlin is good because you're gonna get his flanks in. This one is a ton of fun to mess around with. It can keep wandering on. It can be a fun challenge for you to see how many times you can get it to jump. It's fun. Underrated dome here. I mean this alone already. If you're going to for evolution build with the dragon stuff, you want to have this. But you can stack this with another project, you will see, for more morale damage. Scald is actually a good supportive unit. Yeah, I mean it can inflict insanity. Do I need to say more? It invented bureaucracy too, of course. So, yeah, really evil. And this can snowball really well. This doesn't deserve to be anywhere near mid. Scrying. Yeah, this is a nice gimmick to have, but it's not too fantastic. This is useless. The AI will never send you camouflaged. And yeah, this is okay-ish. Yeah, this is mostly useless too, because most games you will have an ally, right? And they're going to back and forth with the enemy anyway, so you have enough sight to get a rough idea how strong the enemy is. This guy is good because you can really buff him up with later astral with later astral tomes. So yeah, good it goes. Pandemonium. Some hate it, some love it. And this is Astral Shatter's budget version. And Devious Watchers is good because of spells like this one. But in the mountains, AI will never go in the mountains. Spam away. Like, and use the civilian zombies or something similar. Occupy spelljammers and fire this one off. Yeah, you will put a ton of status effects on the enemy anyway, so you can say it's always at 30% extra damage. Just if you dispel status from a friendly, you will see you're often full of them, like 10 of them. So this is more the rule than the exception, and it's free damage. Yeah, obviously this is good. Victory. And this is the interesting part of the spell. This enchantment, it's not a one unit spell as I thought it was. So bastion units, the industrious, you can, yeah, I think they're tier 3, but industrious in general, at least, they are going to love this spell. And if they're getting pummeled anyway, use this. Like if they have decay and this can't go off, just break through the decay and heal them. 25 morale. And of course this is a chaos order too. Against the odds is why I'm going to best this one. This is the first, I think, Warhammer themed tome. This is Slaanesh, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong, it's not what I'm best at. Yeah, but tentacles, I'll leave that implication hanging in the air. Of course, another scaler with stability. This one goes below, so Dark can use it as well, and even more efficiently. Yes, sadomasochism team. But the art is pretty ugly, but again, it's not going to play a role. And these Warhammer tomes are generally very powerful. This Korn. Okay, just get a simple bonus, not much to be said. Yeah, if you're a necro, you may find this interesting, because these decayer zombies, they're not that interesting to keep alive anyway. They'll die at the end of combat, so just throw these cheap guys away. So yeah, it's good. very annoying to fight against, but very nice to have. Breaks decay, of course. I think you can have this on with the Necrospires. Yeah, not as powerful as what we'll see later, but nice to have. This one's nice to have if undead. Very ironic, but you get the spirit resistance. This one is easily in the top. Yeah, there is a demonic version of this. This is a transformation, so you don't have to pay upkeep. It's nice. It is downed. Yeah, you get you not only get to deal damage with the corpse, you get to spawn a phoenix as well. And the phoenix can it can do it again. Yeah, with nature stuff. This can really help you along. And to get a sweet stability. This is why it gets so high. Because you can use your support and battle units, especially if they race trade where you ignore zone of control. You can use those two type of units as frontline units. Yeah, and you will suicide bomb the enemy. So if you want to have a very, and I mean very aggressive play style, love it. And I love to demoralize, go all out of mind control. So yeah, it's for me useless. You only want one race in your empire because of transformations and offset. If I wonder if you break the breakthrough, like the siege is successful and you can attack the city, if you then lift the siege and you then breach again successfully, does it kick off again? Even if it doesn't, it's still a very good ability. Yeah, it's a demoralizing tome, it's meant for that. And this is fun because you can get the units you're not supposed to have. You can get the Corrupt Wizard King. You can get the Karag, but the Karag is very ugly. It will make your whole army look uglier by association. No, you don't want the Karag. Go Wizard King. Yeah, because you can get units you're not supposed to. The Astral Rite can get you a Mage Bane. So if your map is seeded well, Astral Rite, you let it go off. You get a Mage Bane under your control. Having a Mage Bane is even more broken than the Wizard King. Let's just call it that way, because the Wizard Kings are meant to be bosses, basically. The corrupt one. Yeah, this is not a Warhammer one. This is a unit, and you get this. We're not going Shadow for Death Magic. This is amazing. Useless again. And this is nice. Not going in. Good tier. In this secret, it isn't worth much, but always nice to have on top. The fact that Legion is very nice, look what it does. White, yeah, because Whiteborn is in there. It's easily belongs here. Also, Undeath look very goofy with the purple eyes in this game, but yeah. Yeah, use this on a deposable units, huh? Because it doesn't on that, because it cannot lose morale. Yeah, the draft is nice, but then fortification health isn't going to do much. Yeah, this gives you some stability instead of the negative stability. And this hits hard, very, very, very hard for the tier. Because of course you have to take boosts into account, like with an seed road and heart node. Yeah, that's going to boost this. This should be a bit weaker, in my opinion. The shocking phase. It's worth it, especially if a dragon leader just put the Ronin around you. And you'll have strengthened for the powerful despair strike. You can just roar again before the weekend gets too harsh. I don't know how much gold you get. So yeah, can't really say too much about it. This is very nice. Yeah, this is not SOP. This is not really OP, it's fine. It's the next Shadow Flame. I guess you can use this with an Astro Bolt as well. A fortune is nice to have. Yeah, and this is at the previous Shadow Flame Tomes are starting to pay off. Shame with this one is Death Knights are a World of Warcraft thing. That's where it comes from, the anti-paladin. But it doesn't use any World of Warcraft inspired art. But art is very, very good. Like it could be, how do you call it, vanilla. This is an amazing spell, but it costs soul upkeep. So you're going to need to max all the souls we talked about. To keep this up. This is what you get in return. An amazing building. But again rewards both Dark and people that care about stability. Yeah. You just have a hero with a summon. Which you want to do anyway. And if you have the spider bell item. Or summon a decaying zombie. You just destroy them and look what you get back. This unit will carry deep into late game for a tier 3 token. Yeah, this is lovely. If you're an undead build, necromancer's ready, and assault income. Yeah, this is quite overpowered, I would say. There you go. If you're weak to frost, you want to use this, but not anywhere else. Yeah, it's the frostling tome, and you get a letter tome with it. But that one is a mod, and this one is vanilla. But it's not good. Yeah, this one you want to use aggressively. If you have the Phoenix Dome, you not only get to heal because when it dies, after it's used the blessing, of course, but you also get to explode. It's all around good. Some of these modded tomes make vanilla ones especially powerful. I can probably missing some combos, but yeah. This unit underperforms. And I do not... Yeah, this is a racial trait, you can ignore that. But this is... It underperforms sadly. I love the Justiciar team. It's a nice siege project. Yeah, and this is weaker than Parasitic Growth. But Parasitic Growth is overpowered. So yeah, but still very good. And this looks like like a rotten clam or something, or a rotten sandwich. Very grainy, This one is amazing. It's the final rogue dome. Shadow Strikers are back. The Stalkers. And this is why you want, if you're an Astral player, you want to detour from your Astral tomes and take this. Because Astral Attunement is the worst major transformation in the game. Look at all this sweet stuff you get. It's really good. Makes your unit really cool. Make everything black. Gives the shade effect. Yeah. Face beasts are bad. Don't bother with them. Because the displacement. You put them right in the middle of the enemies. You spread out your troops if you face them. You'll face inside your ranks. Yeah. Have fun. You can gank them. The mirror mimic is why you don't want to summon these guys. But do have it ready. Because if you need summons in a pinch and you have these spells prepared, spam them. Because it's still a tier 4 unit and hits like one. And because you can have spells prepared, same reason. Recall leader, and yeah, and recalling circle, you get your whole doom stack back instantly. a bit unreliable, in my opinion. Yeah, this is to keep your sport safe. This is a nothing burger. Those are the most disappointing things in the games. As expected, there were lots of Draenor. These ball tank things. And you get these tiny sad little bombs. But of course you get the Warbreed. Flame bursts. Yeah, you get a summon for a siege. Always nice to have the disposable. But you do not want to use magic to attack for the fight. But the second effect is nice. So yeah, devastation rushing good. Vigor. Yeah, animal. This is nice to get the enemy flanked or to reinforce your frontline. Yeah, if you use this in a higher tier cavalry, you're going to love it. Its super growth is nice, but it's not as awesome as people make it out to be. So yeah, it's a good tome, but it's not top tier. Cycles. And a very good unit. Yeah, this of course is nice to have, especially if you swarm with summons. But the Cycle of Seasons is just useless, let's be real. Yeah, and decay, spread it around. But it's a tier 3. So let's be real. Yeah, the amazing regenerating transformation. Dragons, your mental evolve. Dragon attack, your fire immune at this point anyway. This is bad, don't bother. Yeah, you can really rampage across the map because you can heal very fast with natural generation on it. And my favorite ritual deals a ton of damage to the city defenses. Good summon. Yeah, this is fun on mountainous maps. You can make highly defensible new cities with this. And expand them, because if they get population, you'll just do it again. And with the nature tomes, you can even terraform it into something nice. That's a good tome. Yeah, but it's very situational. But it's fun to play around with. I suggest doing it. A fun fact, this gives you lightning weakness, but gold is more conductive, and it actually gives you resistance to all magic. I've got both. If your skin is with metal, The Faraday cage effect will actually protect your inner organs. So you learn something today. And nice all around. Another water one. This one buffs. Then you get the generation. This enchantment. You can stack it with Draconian. Got nice summons here. If it is a unit you can train, and this is combat summon, and this is a regular summon. This is a pain to fight against. Yeah, really good. This is another ice themed dome, like the mod. Yeah, it does it does give you ice stuff. It does give you defensive stuff. But we'll see with ritual of it. With Hour of the Drowned, the Pirate Dome later. That is just bad. Like, it fits right in with Cold Dark. Do not want to do this. Yeah, I have a mod that makes certain spells evil, especially pillage spells, but it makes sense why this is evil. 60 souls are not worth the population. Another summon good to have, and you gain souls. And they're practically free because you get these fun zombies, of course. Use Sleep of Oblivion and not this one. You do not get to keep it. It's a massive downs crate. And the Reaper is bad. It's a one trick pony. That trick doesn't even go off all the way. And its melee is nothing to write home about. It doesn't even look as good as Age of Wonders 3 Reaper. Okay, this is one of my favorites. This is guaranteed. Keeper's Mark can block it. And it I think it also blocks the insanity, because they never revive after all. Let the fox keep him ready for to replenish. But insanity with a melee attack is not a combo in front of, because it can still attack you. But maybe it's deliberate because balancing, of course. Look at this. This is per turn and not once. And this Wizard King heroes at your side. Over channel, make the entire map black. Everything dies. Yeah, the spell is so disgusting and ugly. And everyone died. The end. And yeah, it will help you at all. Yeah, and this is one in the vanilla game, and it's overpowered, so there you go. And also it says on the tin. Isn't that good, but at how wide it gets, the economy is pretty good. You can use this like civilian zombies. Or to pick off weaker enemies. Nice spell. Net een beloofde transformation, for obvious reasons. Yeah, this is the Phoenix thing, but at the higher, and it's enchantment. But yeah, on it affects less, so it isn't that good. And this one is nice, because you're fighting the AI, they will throw everything to defend even their shitty little two population city. Everything, so you will have like 2 to 3 battles. So go for it. Yeah, Chaos Channing is good. Oh, and the eye, it looks like a pair of lips. And now you can't unsee it, because I can't unsee it. So you have to suffer with me. The first giant dome, and the best one actually. Yeah, the adult magma spirit, you don't get this in vanilla. You can toggle this on and off, fire resistance or weakness. And you have to explode and scorch the... Yeah, a lot of style to mess around with. This looks like a photo and not like game art at all. This one I used a lot in my Dark God Ur playthrough. The best giant gets a runestone and summons such a tower, a fire one. A boring but powerful major. It will be fun if it was compatible with those two. Yeah, let's get to this one. You get the damage reflection. But the rock giant, which I would call the giant. Because yeah, I would expect the standard giant to do what it says for the rock giant. For real. But yeah, it gets strength in other ways, it gets a transformation, so it's still good, just like a fire giant. Scourge Captain. Yeah, and here we're going to see a curse of that drowned aura. And the frost dome is bad. Yeah, it's basically decay. Soul income, we're a bit late at this point. Yeah, and water combat asset is underbaked. Summoning, of course, you get a lot of summoning with all these mods. Good tier. Golden Realm. Yeah, I expect you have a lot of gold. This is what I mean. Yeah, what does this imply? Like, do the smelter corpses or something? It's a bit, yeah, it's a bit dark if you think about it. Yeah, but you, sir, you're overpowered. Not a little bit. And you are overpowered. Like, gilded, very annoying to fight. Hits hard. That golem is a pain in the backside. The only reason this dome wouldn't be sharing a space with the wind dome is because this thing here. Else it will be a never. Like, this is not evil, even though in a mod it should be, but okay. Like, look, and you get bonus for sacrificing higher tier. You summons tier 3, battle summons. But look at the measly damage. Bad. Yeah, bad for the same reason. the cash, you can really bully your city with this. Population is worth more than that. Yeah, of course, you get evil for this. But, I guess if you want to go aggressive, you don't care about the barricading effect that vessels can have. Yeah, this is garbage. Yeah, but you get a demon transformation. But still, same reason as Stone for Souls. Crucible. And this is what Demon Gate can't do, yeah, partly. Look at his damage. Look how this hits. It's just better at destroying things. Get Crucible, not Demon Gate. Yeah, well, if you want transformation, you have to. If this works on enemy terrain, yeah, that is really strong. Because you can do this, and do this if it works. Yeah, with Angel Eyes, this is gonna be really good, because they can't get control loss, Berserk. Yeah, includes. Yeah, again, why would you do this instead of Sleep of Oblivion? Sleep of Oblivion, you pick a mythic unit that's the most back. As it comes back, it's gonna be insane. They're going to attack the enemy in the back after there's much left of him. And this guy, he's really big, but if he is in an enemy zone of control, he has to walk away, and then he can attack again. Like, all he has to do is move his foot up a bit, move it forward, and put it down. Yeah, I always found that funny, but it's a good unit. And the Horn God, if you go to the Ancient Wonders, the trees, the Horn God is always seen as evil, as a villain you have to defeat. But yeah, it's about wrath, so I guess it makes sense. Yeah, this is to expand on a swamp. A very powerful spell, Mass Innervation. And you can combine this with a tier 2 one if you want. But there's some overlap and it won't stack. Yeah, this is a very, very nasty caveat. But the defense you get, of course. And you don't want this with them. Because it will block parasitic growth in those cases. But still. Drowned Goddess. Yeah, what has been said about water combat. And you want the Pirate Dome. And Nimue wasn't as useless as Yaka in the final mission. Idgard is the real MVP. He actually helps you a fight with annoying angel orc. This is the necromantic version is better, in my opinion. But if you ain't, go for it. You have angel eyes. A good spell, of course. And if we're going for evolution build, go for it. You spam this on the young dragons. You're going to have stacks of adult tier 5 dragons. And this is broken as it sounds. Yeah, make it 40, make it 20. All your cities should have a governor, like always. And this guy is okay. But I don't really fear him in battle if I see it. Like, I rush to it. Because it's still a tier 5. And it's one that can't attack if something is in its zone of control. So I still rush at it. But it isn't as annoying as some other of a tier. Exaltation is good tier. No, wrong one. I think Yaka always builds these things. Because it looks like your leader, if I remember correctly. And supreme magic is why you want this tome. A condemn army. Paradise. I can really stack your fortification health, so you have more time to defend your city. But at this time, that shouldn't be a thing. Yeah, this is defensive. And look, you have above a harmony anyway, but this is why this is amazing. Of course, the guy has chosen. If you have a high AP status, charge resist. You have this. So if you have the flanker stuff I've shown, yeah, this will help you there. Okay, I love this one. Because of this little spell, if you have buffed your astral units enough, and especially your summons, you summon this in the back. And it can do, yeah, it deals damage on its creation, and you can kill an archer with flank in one turn. And of course the AI is stupid to turn around and fight it. Yeah, and this Devious Watchers, cheap summon spam. Have fun, because it spawns Corrupt Wizard King, a few tier 3 and 4 in its army, and it's the Evil Neutral, the Marauder. Yeah, and this you don't want to fire, it's the worst transformation in the game. Yeah, to the Wizard King, this can get nice and high. I love Astral Convergence, except for Transformation. You now get Astral Mirror. This is why you don't want the Face Beast. Yeah, this is nice. Can get tanky with this. More aggressive, versatile. This is fun. Getting more and more Mirror Mimic. Very versatile unit and looks like a cheap creepypasta monster. It's nice to have. You can build this in any city and it helps. It is not as good as the demon version to get to, but still, This tome gets way less love than it deserves in these tier lists other people have done, so there we go. One of my favorites. Look at this. Yeah, the Ivory Noble is very, very, very strong and very annoying to fight. Sleep of Oblivion is reserved for these guys if I spot them. But I love using them myself. The Ivory Towers. Nice for income. Valuable mana. Ivory Noble. Mind Blank Bliss. It is a very strong tome. And it's a high tier tome that still looks practical. You can still read it like a book. The final Giant Tome. I guess you can nicely synergize with Nimue's tome, or tomes. But the Storm Giant is still the weakest of the giants. So I have to be honest. Yeah, this one, I need to say very little about it. Now with all these soul mods, I even get more souls. It's the best tome in the entire game, like number one, not tier one, just number one. As opposed to this tome. Only affects elementals. Very good siege units. But tier 5, you have bad, yeah, at tier 3 or 4 you already have good enough siege units. The Titan is quite powerful. And this is quite powerful, but it's a tier 5 tome, it has to compete with other tier 5 tomes. So should I put a mid or a bad? I should have it in bad, because that's what you should feel if you pick this over another tier 5. This is pretty mad. It's okay, it's not bad, but it's a bit boring. Yeah, I don't know if it takes just the leader or the entire stack with him. But because if it takes the stack with him, it can be quite good. You can steal other Ancient Gold Wonders away and loot them. Let me give any remain at this point. There's Dungeoneer all across the map, but I find ID quite fun. But for raiding cities, yeah, you need your Doom stack at 3x6. Yeah, with the Watchers, those floating eye things. You make a hit like a truck, and this is my favorite spell you get. Because the beginning of the combat, you buff up, an enemy buff up, and then you charge. And before you make contact, you make disruption wave go off. All the buffs gone. And the combat becomes one-sided as hell. Have fun! Can we have reanimation at home?
We have reanimation at home, son. Reanimation at home, we like.
Yeah. Yeah, very useful spell to have, very good, of course. This one I love on melee heroes, the two-handers. We'll hit like a truck, killing momentum, have fun. This is for attacking, what you don't see in the most Vanilla Tomes with Order. Beetje heffen. It's good. Again, Impreta, I agree with the meta on this one. This especially Dragon Ruler have fun. This, I like this. This dome is no chill at all. Yeah, this consumes a corpse, just so you know. But I had fun with it. Killing Momentum. Melee Hero, yeah. It looks goofy as hell. It replaces the unit often with those hounds. It is sometimes. Yeah, there's a small chance, but it's like more than 50. So maybe it's a bug, I don't know. You belong there. Why would you want this? I think it's broken because it doesn't work in enemy territory and it doesn't work as advertised. Because if it did, it would actually be really, really nice, but it doesn't do what's supposed to. Yeah, this feels like a tier 4 enchantment. And this account, this is once again a cheap home version of Battlefield Reanimation. So you're going to mid. And then we have a mod version. Yeah, it is obviously based on Crucible, the art, you can tell. It's the opposite of Eternal Lord, because it focuses on a few units, but a few units that are very strong. I mean, come on. Yeah, this goes to best. And we are done. And I could do some shuffling, because a lot of us in good right now. We could put you up a tier. Okay, a penguins in hindsight. Your sheltering boar. I think should be mid, to be if you're going to be honest. This too. Yeah, this one too. With the and a Moonwalk Grove. Like, I mean, even a lot of tier 1 units will push an AI away with aggressive AI mode. You won't attack. So yeah. Yeah, you don't need to quickly be back. And this, it comes a bit too late, the doubling of high stability. Yes, that's what I was looking for. I mean, with the other mods, make this one really powerful. We have to look at the individual, but also the collective value. Yeah, to be honest, I feel I would be dishonest if I kicked more tomes out of good. Again, this game is very well designed. And lots of love and soul put into it. And I just feel a lot of tomes are just good. It gives me a meh reaction. Yeah, it's nothing special. But the modders, yeah, I just don't think that in good faith I can argue differently. This is my tier list. Link in the description. Like and subscribe. Over 6 months I make another video in another video game. Let's be honest. Yeah. Give the modders some love. They deserve it. Yeah, this is the end. Leave a comment if you disagree or agree. It's all fine. I won't delete or filter them. As long as it's not offensive, it'll stay. Goodbye, guys.